feel this way, a musical instrument, but still feel like you can. As long as you do the job at the end. Hello.
It was cool.
Yeah. All right. See you guys. All right, let's get to some questions. I know you guys have been waiting for a while. How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Very good.
So my question is, since Sam's hair obviously has magical properties.
Since Sam's hair has I'm sorry.
Why are you thinking it leashed?
Yeah, that's magical, all right.
Let her talk.
That's me.
Someone said sing.
It's a crap sweat. Thank you so much.
Hi.
Jared.
Hi.
My question.
Wait, say that again. I'm so sorry.
What?
You said Jared?
Say hi, Jared Jensen.
Oh, hi.
First of all, you have to speak to Hare directly.
Hi,
Hare.
Hello. You should be German. Uns hallo.
I love it. I love it. You know she should be German, and so I'm just going to add uns.
I'm not even saying in German, no.
Uns, of course. Uns, that's your good German accent. I never heard this here because I saw
it. Like a
Dating or life advice, and how does it differ from Sam and Dean?
This just got serious.
I can say that nobody that I've dated ever, I never killed anybody I dated.
I never saw anyone ever die supernaturally.
I'm on the ceiling burning.
I've never dated anyone that actually that turned into an actual demon. I had some that acted like they did. But never actually. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Oh well, there was no advice there. I guess there's two schools of thought. One, be yourself. The other, do whatever you can. Be whoever she needs you to be. Or he needs you to be. Or whatever it is that you're trying to accomplish. Be a shapeshifter.
Where did she go?
What does that mean?
It's German.
It's German. Is there anybody? Is there a German out there anymore? Okay. Does that help you understand English when someone has an "ins" in front of it?
What does?
No.
Nine. I heard nine.
Nine. That's just that means no.
I heard nine.
Oh, that's the answer to their question. I'm asking them if "unks" means anything, and they're saying nine.
It's a term of endearment.
What?
It doesn't mean anything.
Is it like
That's a fake German accent. That's not even a German accent.
No, I'm Asian.
You're Asian? What does that mean, German?
This just got wacky.
Just got wacky?
Just got. Right then.
Okay, I said corrected. Oh. I said corrected.
I mean no!
Yes. Yeah, we got that. No. I'm sorry. We have that.
I stand corrected, said the man to his pedometers.
Convince him that they had, in fact, a very good voice.
Did we kill Santa Claus?
It was a tooth fairy. Tooth fairy.
Of course.
I think, and having spent some time on the Men of Letters set, I think Sam would ask for a more comfortable bed. Because they suck. We have a fridge in there that can hold beer or wine or whatever, but the boys never strap a mattress to the top of the Impala to take home, which we did. Remember that? Here's a funny story, we've never told this. So, in season what, four and five? Seasons four and five, the place that Jensen had stayed in downtown Vancouver was being reoccupied by his stuntman buddy, who had moved back to
Thurman. A tenant. They would be the owner of the suite. I was renting the place for the first couple seasons, and then I got a phone call, and he's a stunt guy in Vancouver. He's like, hey man, girlfriend and I broke up, and I'm gonna need the apartment back. Okay. So I was telling Jared the dilemma. I'm like, I gotta go out and now hunt for a new place to stay in Vancouver. And he was just like, well, I've got a basement suite in the house I just bought. I'll just stay there until you find something. So I was like, all right, but I don't have any furniture, a bed, or anything, because I was renting a furnished place. So he's like, that's fine. We'll just go get a mattress and throw it down and it'll be good. Because, you know, guys don't need much, but all I needed was a mattress. And so, cut to Jared and I driving to Mattress World or whatever it was,
mattress.
A few miles away. And
we bought the mattress, but
they didn't have any.
They had 2 weeks for delivery or something? Why did
they? Yeah, I don't know. They were like, it's going to be like 3 or 4 weeks delivery, or you can just pick it up at a warehouse. We're like, he's got an SUV. We'll just drive over there and pick it up. Thinking they would have some sort of a tie-down mechanism
at the warehouse,
which they don't. So, to Jared driving and me sitting on the passenger windowsill,
which, by the way, we only realized because as we were driving, and we had had like one bungee or one string or something, we didn't just balance on them. We had a box spring and a mattress on top of the SUV.
Yeah, oh, yeah, that whole that's good, let's go.
We had a big mess of masking tape and it worked. So we're driving down, and the only reason we really occurred to us that the mattresses might be falling off the roof is because on this really crowded Vancouver City street, the nearest car behind us was like 200 feet. And people driving going like, I ain't gonna do that damn thing. Yeah. So Jensen's like, I got it. Rolls out of the window.
Yeah, we're driving across the bridge, like over a very large river, and I look out my passenger window, and I see the corner of the mattress is like here, and I'm like, whoa, slow down.
So I'm going like 20 miles an hour, like 50 miles an hour or something.
So we roll the window down. I sit up.
He's sitting on the windowsill, on the windowsill like this. Like
he's out of the car.
He's hanging out, just like chilling out. Like, yeah.
So we drove for probably a good 5 miles like that. Yeah. Through like downtown Vancouver.
The best part is when finally the nearest car to us, which was a quarter mile back, decided it was safe enough to come approach. It was a minivan of like five girls.
Yeah, they pulled up beside us. And I'm like sitting like this and they pull up right next to us. And I'm like, it was up. And the mom rolls down the window and there's she's got like 3 or 4 teenage girls in the backseat, and they're like, oh my gosh, are you having Supernatural?
And I go,
no, but this guy is.
And then that's how I lean forward, I'm like, we got this.
And then the minivan door slides open, and there's all these teenage girls, and I'm like,
oh!
And they're like, yep, just a couple of dudes getting the mattress. Have a good afternoon, guys.
So the same thing you can write to Santa Claus, they would ask for bungee cords.
Oh yeah, that's right. That's definitely what we would need. Some tie-downs.
What's the weapons? What's the gem ones?
Thank you.
Hi, guys. So this is actually a more serious question for Jensen. we all will be together if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Have yourself a merry little Christmas.